Welcome to the next session on functional analysis. In this session, we will be discussing the topic Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure, which is a procedure used to construct an orthonormal system from a linearly independent system. So, the procedure is this theorem. Let xi where I greater than or equal to 1 be a linearly independent system in a Hilbert space H. So we are given a linearly independent system x1, x2, x3, etc. And we are defining En as x1 by norm of x1 if n is equal to 1 and xn minus yn divided by norm of xn minus yn where n greater than or equal to 2, where yn is defined as summation I is equal to 1 to n minus 1 inner product xn ei ei. And the theorem says that this system of vectors ei where I greater than or equal to 1 is an orthonormal system, and it has the property that span of e1 e2 etc en is equal to span of x1, x2, etc., xn for each n element of natural numbers. So, for each n, we have the property span of e1, e2, etc., en is equal to span of x1, x2, etc., xn. Okay. So, we will be using mathematical induction to prove the theorem. So, first, I will take a single vector x1. And we'll prove the theorem. So, we are given that xi where I greater than or equal to 1 is a linearly independent system. And we know that in a linearly independent system, there is no role for a zero vector. There will not be a zero vector in any linearly independent system. So, here, since x1, x2, etc., xn, etc. is a linearly independent system, none of these xi's are 0. So, xi not equal to 0 for all I greater than or equal to 1. If xi not equal to 0, then clearly norm of xi not equal to 0 for all I greater than or equal to 1. Here, we have defined e1 as x1 by norm of x1. So, what will be norm of e1? Norm of e1 will be norm x1 by norm x1, which is equal to 1. And it's because norm of x1 not equal to 0, we can say that norm of e1 equal to 1. So, norm of e1 equal to 1, therefore the singleton set e1, the singleton set e1 is an orthonormal system in H. It is a trivial result. Any unit vector in an inner product space forms an orthonormal system, a single vector. So, we have set E1 is an orthonormal system in H. What is E1? It's a scalar multiple of X1. If E1 and X1 are scalar multiples of each other, then it is clear that span of E1 will be same as span of X1. So, we have set E1 is an orthonormal system and span of E1 equal to span of X1. Or we can say that the result is true when there is only a single vector. So, the theorem holds if the linearly independent system contains, it's not linear system, it is linearly independent system contains only one vector. Now, we are assuming the result is true for n minus 1. That means, if we are taking n minus 1 vectors x1, x2, etc., xn minus 1, then the collection e1, e2, etc., en minus 1 is an orthonormal system, and the span of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1 is same as span of x1, x2, etc., xn minus 1. We are assuming this. Now, en, what is en? Xn minus yn by norm of xn minus yn. We should First we should verify that xn not equal to yn, because if xn equal to yn, this will be of the form 0 by 0 form. Okay, so it is not well, it will not be well defined. So first we will prove that xn not equal to yn. So what is xn? We are given that xi, where I greater than or equal to 1, is a linearly independent system. If it is a linearly independent system, any subset of this collection is a linearly independent set. So x1, x2, etc., xn is a linearly independent set. So you cannot write xn as a finite linear combination of, or a linear combination of x1, x2, etc., xn minus 1. So xn is not an element of span of x1, x2, etc., xn minus 1. And we have assumed that span of x1, x2, etc., xn minus 1 is same as span of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1. So we have xn is not an element of span of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1. Okay. Now what about yn? Yn is defined as summation I is equal to 1 to n minus 1, inner product xn ei ei. Okay. And this from the definition of yn, it is clear that yn is a scalar it's a linear combination of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1. So if yn is a linear combination of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1, then yn is an element of span of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1. So xn is not here, but yn is here. So, can xn and yn coincide? No. So, we can say that xn not equal to yn. Okay. So, we can define en as xn minus yn divided by norm of xn minus yn for all n greater than or equal to 2. Okay. Also, it is clear that norm of en will be norm of xn minus yn divided by norm of xn minus yn, which is same as 1. Now, to complete the proof, we have to show that, first we have to show that the vectors e1, e2, etc., en are pairwise orthogonal. Already we have assumed that e1, e2, etc., up to en minus 1, it is an orthonormal system, means e1, e2, etc., en minus 1 are all pairwise orthogonal. So it's enough to show the orthogonality of e1, e2, etc., en minus 1 with the en. Okay. So we need to prove that en is orthogonal to, en is orthogonal to e1, en is orthogonal to e2, etc., en is orthogonal to en minus 1. This we have to prove. So I am taking I less than n, and I have to show that inner product of en ei equal to 0. So let I be less than 1. What is inner product of en ei? En is xn by yn by norm of xn by yn. Okay. And 1 by norm of xn minus yn is a scalar. You can take it outside because inner product is linear with respect to the first variable. So this is 1 by norm of xn minus yn into inner product xn minus yn ei. And again, using linearity of inner product, we can write this as 1 by norm of xn minus yn into inner product xn ei minus inner product yn ei. Now we may evaluate what is inner product of yn ei. Inner product of yn ei is equal to inner product of, substitute the expression for yn here, summation j is equal to 1 to n minus 1, inner product xn ej ej comma ei. And inner product is linear with respect to the first variable. So you can write this as summation j is equal to 1 to n minus 1, and take the scalars outside, inner product xn ej what remains is inner product of Ej and Ei. Okay. Note that we have assumed that I is less than N. Okay. And J varies from 1 to N minus 1. If I is less than 1, if I is less than N, I is also in 1, 2, etc. up to N minus 1. So that Ei and Ej are, they are pairwise orthogonal. Okay. So inner product of Ej, Ei, this is equal to 1 if J is equal to I, 0 otherwise. So in this summation, only one term will survive. That is when J is equal to Y, we may have a non-zero quantity. Otherwise, all other terms are 0. When J not equal to I, all other terms are 0. So when J is equal to I, what remains is inner product of Xn Ei into inner product of Ei Ei. But inner product of Ei Ei is equal to 1. So we got inner product of Xn Ei, inner product of Yn Ei and inner product of Xn Ei are same. So here we are taking their difference. This will be equal to 0. So En is orthogonal to all Ei where I is less than N. Or in other words, we can say that the collection of vectors E1, E2, etc., En are pairwise, that forms an orthonormal system, because we have already proved that norm of En is equal to 1. Now what remains to prove is we have to show that span of E1, E2, etc., En is same as span of X1, X2, etc., Xn. It's an easy task. We know that En is equal to Xn minus Yn divided by norm of Xn minus Yn. And what is Yn? It is summation I equal to 1 to N minus 1 inner product of Xn Ei Ei. Okay. So the expression for Yn shows that Yn is an element of span of E1, E2, etc. En minus 1. And by our induction hypothesis, span of E1, E2, etc., En minus 1 is same as span of X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1. Okay. So, Yn is an element of span of X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1. Or I can write Yn as summation I equal to 1 to N minus 1, some alpha I, Xi. Now, En can be written as 1 by norm of Xn minus Yn into Xn minus Yn. Yn is an element of span of X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1. Okay. So, in general, we can say that this is some scalar into Xn minus an element of span of X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1 means summation I equal to 1 to N minus 1 alpha I Xi. So we have X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1 and Xn here. So this En will be an element of span of X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1. Okay. Already by our assumption, span of E1, E2, etc., En minus 1 is same as span of X1, X2, etc., Xn minus 1. And now we have En is an element of span of X1, X2, etc., Xn. So, it is clear that span of E1, E2, etc., En is same as span of X1, X2, etc., Xn. So, hence our theorem is true. Okay. So, this procedure is being used to construct an orthonormal system from a linearly independent system. And this procedure is known as Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure. Okay, this is a highly useful result in linear algebra, functional analysis and all other branches of mathematics. And we will continue our discussion on Hilbert spaces in our next session. Till then.